Hello children, in the previous video, I have taught you about how to solve the multiplication, that is how to do the multiplication of two rational numbers that I have taught you in the previous video. Now let us discuss about what are the properties of multiplication of rational number. So far we have already studied about the properties of addition of rational number and also we studied the properties for subtraction of rational number. Similarly, now we will be going to study about the properties of multiplication of rational numbers. I think you can recall the properties, right? What are the properties? Closure property, commutative property, associative property. This is what till now we have studied. Remaining are new things, okay? Now, closure property. It states that if A by B and C by D are two rational numbers, then A by B into C by D, it should be a rational number. That is called as closure property, okay? That is, in case of addition, you are getting plus here. And in case of subtraction, you are getting minus here. Similarly, in case of multiplication, we have to put into. See, if we take any two rational number, one rational number is A by B and another one rational number is C by D. And if we multiply both of them, the result whatever we will be getting, that should again be a rational number. Then we can tell like multiplication of rational numbers, they satisfy closure property. Okay? Now let me take one example and let me show you how it will satisfy the closure property. See, A by B, let me take one rational number. That is 2 by 3 into C by D, it is nothing but another rational number. Let me take it as minus 5 by 6. Is it a rational number? Yes, of course. Okay. Now let me multiply these two. Here there is minus, so we should go for integer rules. That is plus into minus is minus. 2 5 is 10 divided by 3 6 is 18. Minus 10 by 18. Is it a rational number? Yes, of course. It is said to be a rational number. So, if I take any two rational numbers and if I multiply it, again the product whatever I will be getting, that will be again a rational number. So, multiplication of rational numbers, they will satisfy closure property. Okay, the next property is commutative property. It states that if A by B and C by D are two rational numbers, then A by B into C by D, it should be equal to C by D into A by B. That is, if we consider any two rational number and if I multiply it in this way and if I make it exchange, I mean 2 into 3, if I make it 3 into 2 also, I should get same result. That is what this property states. Okay, now let us check whether the multiplication of rational numbers will satisfy the commutative property or not. Let me verify it by taking two examples. See, A by B, it is nothing but 1 by 2. Okay, this is one rational number into C by D, it is nothing but 3 by 4. Can I take it? Yes, of course. So, this is said to be A by B into C by D. Okay, now let me solve this part. 1 3 is 3. 2 4 is 8. So, LHS part, I got the result as 3 by 8. Okay, now let me solve for the RHS part. C by D, it is nothing but 3 by 4. Okay, into A by B is nothing but 1 by 2. Let me multiply these two. 3 1 is 3 divided by 4 2 is 8. Now we observe students, in LHS also I got the result as 3 by 8. And by solving RHS also I got the result as 3 by 8. So I can tell like, yes, multiplication of rational numbers, they will satisfy the commutative property. And the commutative property for multiplication, it is stated as A by B into C by D, it should be equal to C by D into A by B. In addition, everything is same. Instead of into, you should put plus. And in subtraction, everything is same. Instead of into, I should put minus. And for subtraction, the commutative property is not satisfied. I have already explained it and I have proved it as well by taking one or two examples. Okay? Keep in mind, it is very much important. Next, the third property is associative property. What does this associative property state? It states that if I take three rational numbers, that is one is A by B and another one is C by D and another one is E by F, then A by B into C by D into E by F, it should be equal to A by B into C by D into E by F. Then I can tell like, yes, multiplication of rational numbers, it will satisfy the associative property. Let me verify it by taking one example. Okay, I will take A by B as 1 by 2. And I will take C by D as 3 by 2. And I will take E by F as 1 by 4. Okay. Let me put bracket for first 2. And let me solve it. Always solve the given thing in bracket first. 1 3 is 3. 2 2 is 4. Into 1 by 4. Which is equal to 3 by 4 4 is 16. So this part I got as 3 by 16. Now let me take same numbers. And let me multiply it in this manner. A by 2 here I took 1 by 2, here also 1 by 2. Into C by 2 I took as 3 by 2, here also 3 by 2. Into E by F here is 1 by 4, here also take as 1 by 4. Okay, always multiply the given thing in bracket first. So 3 1s is 3, 2 4s is 8, 1 3s is 3, 2 8s is 16. See, both LHS and RHS result is same. 3 by 16, 3 by 16. So I can tell something like, yes, multiplication of rational numbers, they will satisfy associative property for multiplication. Okay. Next, the fourth property is multiplicative identity. In case of addition, while teaching the properties of addition, I told you as additive identity, correct? Which number will call it as additive identity? 0. Why will we call 0 as additive identity? Because 0, when it is added to any number, I will get the result as that number itself. Okay? Similarly, while multiplying, which number if I multiply, I will get the result as same that number only? 1, correct? See, if I take 1, 1 into 2, 2, 1 into 3, 3, 1 into 5, 5, 1 into 2 by 3, 2 by 3. So, 1, when it is multiplied with any number, it will give the result as that number itself. So, we can call 1 as multiplicative identity. Okay? The fifth property is multiplicative inverse. It is also called as reciprocal. What is this multiplicative inverse or reciprocal? If we take any rational number, that is A by B, its multiplicative inverse will be, its multiplicative inverse will be B by A. Okay? That is, we should make numerator as denominator, denominator as numerator. Okay? While teaching the addition, I taught you as additive inverse, where you will be just changing the sign. A by B. Additive inverse means minus A by B. Similarly, in multiplication, we have one more inverse that is called as multiplicative inverse. It is nothing but making numerator as denominator, denominator as numerator. Let me give an example. If they give you the number like 2 by 3, then what is its multiplicative inverse? It will be equal to 3 by 2. Change numerator as denominator, denominator as numerator. This is how you need to solve. Okay? Multiplicative inverse, it is also called as reciprocal. Multiplicative inverse means making numerator as denominator, denominator as numerator. Which number is called as multiplicative identity? 1. Like this, they can ask you one more question. So, be prepared for it. Okay, students? This is very easy concept. Okay, just learn it. Okay, students? Sixth property. The sixth property is distributive property. Okay? If I take any three rational numbers, that is A by B, C by D and E by F, the distributive property states that A by B into C by D plus E by F, which is equal to A by B into C by D plus A by B into E by F. That is, this A by B, it is multiplied for both. And their product should be added. That is the meaning of it. A by B into C by D plus E by F, it is nothing but A by B into C by D plus A by B into E by F. Okay? That is what the distributive property of multiplication over addition states. Okay? Next, the last but not the least property is multiplicative property of 0. What is this multiplicative property of 0? 0, if I take and if I multiply to any number, either it can be 2 by 3 or it can be 1 by 4. Or it can be 100 by 3, whatever the number may be, if I multiply it with 0, the product whichever I will be getting now, that will be always 0. So, this is one of the multiplicative property of 0. That is, 0 if it is multiplied with any number, the product whatever we will be getting is always 0. Okay, students, let me give a quick recall about all the properties. Okay, the first property is closure property. Okay, closure property, multiplication it will satisfy. That is, if I multiply any two numbers, the result whatever I will be getting is again a rational number. Next, commutative property, ACD is satisfied. The property states that A by B into B, C by D, it will be equal to C by D into A by B. Next, associative, it states like this. Just now I told, that is the bracket thing, we can't tell. We just want to write and practice it. Okay, next. Multiplicative identity means 1. Multiplicative inverse or reciprocal means making numerator as denominator, denominator as numerator. Distributive property, it is actually very important one which you will be using while solving the problems which can be asked for 3 marks. So, you just mug up this formula without fail, okay? Next, multiplicative property of 0. This is just like you should use it in the problems, okay? Like this, if I give you like 0 into 100 by 3, multiply numerator, denominator and all. We can directly write it as 0 into anything is always 0. Okay? For that situations, we will be using it. Students, you just copy all these things to your classwork and you just make a practice of it. Thank you, students.